wow, how would you like to follow that? My name's Dr. Matt Manweller, and I'm a professor of political sciences, and I'm actually a conservative. And I was actually glad to see all the generational parasites come out today, because I wanted us to hear them. Why do I call them generational parasites? I call them generational parasites because they have such a massive sense of entitlement that they think they're entitled to the wealth and resources and opportunity of the generation that will come after them. Well, guess what? The generation that comes after them, those are my kids. And so I don't care if they show up with 1 or 10,000. If they're coming for my kids, they're coming through me first. When I was walking up here, it reminded me of the movie Braveheart. A small group of Irishmen and a large British army. It reminded me of one particular scene. William Wallace was about to head over to the British, and one of the Irish guys grabs him and says, "Where are you going?" He says, "I'm going to pick a fight." Well, yeah, I think this is a fight worth picking. I really do. Folks, 10 years from now, we're going to look back. And 10 years from now, we are either going to be Greece, where we have abandoned our public policy to state unions, or we're going to be the America of the 1980s. We will either won or lost, but regardless of whether we win or lose, we're going to look at this moment in time and say, this is where the battle was fought, this is where the battle was won, or this is where the battle was lost. Now, let me tell you something about the people who walked away. They are far more opinionated than they are educated. And their fiery passion is only matched by the immeasurable breadth of their ignorance. And we should take them seriously, folks, because passionately ignorant people is where bad public policy comes from. Folks, we can't do anything about their passion, but maybe, just maybe, we can do something about their ignorance and their faith-based economics. I'm a professor of political science, so I deal in facts and data and research, and I brought you some today. You can take the nerd out of the cold, but you can't take the nerd out of the professor, so here we go. According to the National Institute of Labor Relations, there are 22 right-to-work states, and there are 28 union shop states. In the 22 right-to-work states, in the last 10 years, real personal income has gone up 28%. In the union states, 14%. You are twice as better off in a right-to-work state as you are a union state. And these guys, these generational parasites, they wave their save the middle class. We're saving the middle class. You want to look at job growth? In the 22 right-to-work states, they added 1.5 million new private sector jobs. In the union shop states, they lost 1.8 million jobs. That's a difference of 3.3 million jobs between a union shop state and the right-to-work state. We're building the middle class. They're undermining the middle class. If you look at the unemployment rates in all the 22 right-to-work states, the average unemployment is 8%. If you look at the union shop states, it's 9.1%. That is a 1.1 difference, lower unemployment in our right-to-work states, and that would translate to 65,000 jobs in Washington. If you're excited about the Boeing tanker deal we got last week, we could get 6 jobs worth of those if we just made our state a right-to-work state. Of the 10 states with the lowest unemployment in America right now, 8 of them are right-to-work states. Only 2 of them are union states, and one of those is Montana. A lot of my friends say, hey, we've lost a lot of jobs. A lot of my friends in Michigan and Wisconsin, they say, we lost a lot of jobs. I say, no, you haven't lost any jobs. I know exactly where your jobs are. They're in South Carolina, they're in Nebraska, they're in Kansas, they're in other right-to-work states. As long as we live in a world where labor and capital is mobile, Boeing doesn't need to go to China when it can go to South Carolina. GM doesn't need to go to Mexico when it can go to Louisiana. How obvious do you need to see the writing on the wall? Let me ask you a few simple questions. Can anybody here, can any of the generational parasites who walked away, can any of them name one single industry in America with heavy union involvement that is thriving? Can you name one? What about the auto industry? The UAW-led auto industry, are they thriving? What about our WEA K through 12 system? Is it thriving? What about our states led by our SEIU and our ASME? Are they thriving? No! And if you don't want to go by industry, let me ask you a similar question. Can you name a single state or municipality that has heavy union involvement that's thriving? How many of you want to be the next Detroit? Yay! Let's be Detroit, really? Or how about California or New York? Can you name a single municipality or state with heavy union involvement that is thriving? And the answer is no. These guys are the polar opposite of King Midas. Everything King Midas turned touched to gold. Everything they touch turns to crap, right? And I want their hands off of my state and my children's future. Their idea, this is what their idea is. The people who brought you the Pinto, failed K-12 schools and bankrupt states, they want to be in charge of your economic future. Who thinks that's a good idea? Absolutely. These are some simple questions, folks. I'm gonna be quick because I know it's cold. I may be hot right now, but I know you're cold. We're going to have some simple questions to ask of the state. How do you want to spend your money? Do you want to spend your money on union benefits or educating your children? Do you want to spend your money on union retirement plans or do you want to spend it on your health care? Do you want to spend your money on union perks and double dippers or do you want to spend it on nursing homes for our elderly and our parents? These questions are simple. They're so simple that even the guys that walked away should be able to answer them. Let's keep their hands out of Washington. Let's keep our money where it belongs. I appreciate you guys coming out here. I know it's cold. Stand with Governor Walker. Stand with Mitch Daniels. Stand with Governor Kasich. And let your voices be heard. Thank you very much.